Hi guys and welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to do an exciting update for Panda Palette for 2020. I have done some damage and some changes and yeah, I have strengthened my Panda Palette and I have made a whole video about it last month if you want to see that. I think it is like 2 or 3 weeks since I did this. Maybe it's 2 weeks since you saw it. I have strengthened some more shadows for my Panda Palette this year to get through the old shadows that I don't want to throw out, that I want to use up. Let's just roll the pictures from last update and let me show you where I am now with the shadows. And I will explain when we get to how it is looking now. This is my Panda Palette now. I don't know if I'm even a part of the Panning Solitaire theme from the Fantastic Ladies anymore. It's really my own palette now. It's not really making sense to call it Panning Solitaire, so I don't know what I will do from here on now. According to that hashtag and everything like that, I don't think it's fair to use the hashtag when the shadows are not really making sense anymore. Let me go through the shadows one by one and talk about them if it was a Panning Solitaire update, right? What I had for my single shadow is not in this palette anymore. It is this empty pan right here. And this has been empty for quite a while now because I did franking that into this green shade plus some of the rose gold shade that is a part of the duo with that shade right there. I franking some of that into the green which I have on my lower lash line today. I think that is the first time the last month that I have used that shade. So that is not really exciting. So that is an update for the green. I don't have progress. Only for one. Oh, maybe I used it one more time. Doesn't really matter. Then there's no progress on the green at all. One part of the duo and the single I'm calling done. And I'm just going to call it done. I don't care anymore. I really don't. Oh yeah. Exciting news. I finished the pink shade that I had in my two franking shadows that was part of the rose gold shade. So that is done. I'm not going to update you on that anymore, obviously. So yes, the taupe shade from the duo, all of that is in the remaining five franking shadows. No, four. These four, right? There's no taupe in the green. Franking shadows I am working on daily. I wear them all the time. And since I did the franking video, I hit pan on the orange, this one right there, and then the blue. There's not that much of the blue, so it was fairly easy to hit pan. I think I used it maybe twice, and then I hit pan, or in two eye looks, I should say. I have used it a lot on my lower lash line, and I have used it a few times on my lid, but it's not really what I want in the blue. I don't really want a blue, but I think a blue on the lower lash line is fun. Yeah, I guess that is done. Don't do this with a shadow that is so empty. The rest of the taupe fell on my leg and then some on my carpet, and my carpet is not clean, so that part I'm going to throw out. Okay, let me take a break and I will show you how much I can save and how much that is going from the taupe shade. I hate that I didn't take a picture before, but I guess I can take a screenshot from the video. Okay, I'll be right back. I'm a mess. I'm sorry. Okay, I'm going to talk that like this because then it won't fall off again. That is how much I saved that landed on my thigh. And this is the part that I could salvage from the floor. But that is going in the trash because that is disgusting and my carpet is not clean. I don't want any dust and everything on my eyes. But this I can repress or do some franking with. I haven't decided yet at all. But this is going to be saved. So let me put that in my sea palette. And this is trash. So that was unfortunate. And I'm a mess. I'm very sorry. I'm sweaty, I'm oily, and I'm pregnant, and yeah. Let's talk about my palette without that shiny pan now. I have tried to focus on the purple Franken Shadow for the last month the most, because that is the oldest Franken Shadow that I want to have gone. Because I have been wearing purple and pink so much and I just want it gone, basically. But I have tried to pair the purple with the other colors, mostly the blue. Otherwise, I have done some looks with the yellow and the orange together. And actually, I have used the orange in the crease sometimes, even though there's a sheen to it. It's actually also very pretty in the crease transition area. Today I have the yellow on the lid, this one right there, this one in my brows, this in my outer corner, I think, and then the green on my lower lash line. And they're not really buildable, they're very sheer, but that's a really good thing about these three shades, because they are kind of colorful, and that means I can wear them to work without it being too bold. The green is very bold, I think. But I have been loving wearing the purple and the orange on my eyelid at work, because they're kind of natural, and I really like that. But let me just tell you, I have 2 weeks left of work before I go on maternity leave, and then I can wear whatever I want if I am going to wear makeup. I hope so, because I really want to finish more of these shadows before the end of the year. Baby girl is coming in October. 16th of October is my due date, so my maternity leave is 4 weeks before that. My plan is to wear makeup most days. Let's see, I'm not very good at wearing makeup when I don't go places and if I'm just staying home. But yes, I'm going to do my best. But yes, if you want to see how I made these three Franken shadows, you should check out the Franken video, and I share in that video which shades I have mixed them with to make them. So for my trio, you can see there's only two shades left. And that is because I finished the light brown. And I finished it because I frankened it with a small part of my Franken bronzer, because that fell on the floor as well. Packaging closed, obviously. So I can call that shadow completely done. So I have been using this the past week in my brows, and I actually really like that. And I have used it a few times in my crease as well. I've been focusing on my MAC Wedge eyeshadow that I have in my Graveyard Project pan for the last month in my crease. So this has been very nice as well to pair with it and use in my brows. I've just been loving that. So I don't know how I'm going to go through these. I have thought about frankening them or mixing them all together or something like that to make one big brow powder, because I use so many different shades in my brows that I don't want to use on my eyes, basically. I really like this in my brows, but on my eyes it's not the best. Plus this MAC Wedge, I use that in my crease and that is enough. Lot of thoughts, let's just say like that. So that is my update for my trio. I don't think there's much progress, and other than I expanded that pan a small bit. Goals for next update is to have half of the purple done. I want to expand the pan in the blue and the orange, and I want to hit pan on the green. I do think I can hit pan on the yellow as well, so having pan on all of them would be really nice. I'm 100% clear with me not hitting pan on this darker gray-ish shade down there in the corner, the Catrice single shadow. It is called Game of Stones. I still think that is a funny name. I think that is my goal, to hit pan on everything of my Franken shadows, and then finish half of the purple. So that is my update for my Panda palette. I feel like I'm stealing the Panning Solitaire hashtag, because it's not really a part of the Panning Solitaire anymore, because I have frankened so many shadows. And now I can I'm just working on this. It's not like in the format that I have had it so far. So let me know. Should I keep stealing the hashtag or should I just call it Panda Palette for now? Next year I'm going to do something totally different. I don't think I'm going to do a Panda Palette. Maybe Pando's eyeshadows. You guys commented that you were kind of excited about that. And some of you has also suggested it to me to do that next year. So I think I'm going to do that because I am on maternity leave for the most of 2021. It's really, really weird to say that already. So I think I can get away with semi-colorful looks and stuff like that. Let me stop rambling and wrap up this video. I hope you guys enjoyed, and until my next video, please take care in this weird world we are living in right now. And yeah, I hope you are going to take care, and see you in my next one. Bye.